Coming up in the news, a member of Parliament for North Abaco commending residents. Find out why. 56 new cases of COVID-19 confirmed in the country. The majority of those cases in Grand Bahama. And a small business finding ways to keep its doors open. The Bahamas Tonight, the Northern Edition, starts now.
This is the Bahamas Tonight, Northern Edition.
This is the Bahamas Tonight, the Northern Edition. Good evening, I'm Italia Hall. Thank you so much for tuning in. Topping the news, the fight against COVID-19 remains a serious challenge for many countries around the world, and the Bahamas is no exception. About 1 month ago, COVID-19 numbers increased tremendously in New Providence and on the island of Abaco. Those numbers prompted health officials to recommend several restrictive measures to slow the spread of the deadly virus. And now it appears as if numbers on those islands are decreasing. Well, tonight, the Member of Parliament for North Abaco is commending residents for their sacrifice and is reminding them to remain vigilant. Following Abaco's increase in COVID numbers last month, several restrictive measures were implemented. But since then, reports have shown that numbers have decreased significantly. Member of Parliament for North Abaco, the Honorable Darren Henfield, says COVID-19 is a serious concern for him, and it is evident that the measures that were put in place on Abaco helped to mitigate the spread of the virus.
So obviously the measures that we took to mitigate the spread of COVID worked in Abaco, and we've seen them work elsewhere in the Bahamas. You can see some site cases like Trinity, like Grand Bahama. We await to see in New Providence, and the numbers are way down in New Providence as well. I think they're trending downward. So these measures are extremely important, I think, to fight and mitigate the spread of COVID in our islands and Abaco. I'm very proud of Abaconians who have been able to take seriously the message of social distancing and wearing masks and sanitizing and obeying the protocols that have been put in place to mitigate the spread of COVID. I'm very proud.
He says Abaconians must not let their guards down.
COVID is still impacting the lives of people, even unto death, in this country. This is no time to let your guard down. We are encouraged by the news that we're pretty close to a vaccine. When that happens, that's going to benefit not only the Bahamas, but the entire world. But this is no time to, as we say in the church, this is no time to slack your ride. This is a time to hold firm to what you know has brought you safe this far.
He adds that persons must be mindful during this period.
It is unfortunate that we continue, some of us, to ignore the fact that COVID is actually taking lives in the Bahamas. And I think many of us now know some person, some individual that has actually succumbed to COVID. And so this is not a time now to relax. This is a time now to hold firm, because as a collective, we can only do this if we work together. As a country, as a people, and as a collective of citizenry.
And now to the latest COVID-19 health statistics. 56 new confirmed cases of COVID were confirmed by the Ministry of Health yesterday. The total number of confirmed cases now stands at 7,312. Of those 56 cases, 7 cases are in New Providence, 22 cases on Grand Bahama, 2 cases in Abaco, 2 in Bimini, 6 cases in Eleuthera, 16 cases in Exuma, and 1 case in Andros. Now 83 recoveries were reported, a total of 25 cases are hospitalized. 7 of those cases are in hospital on Grand Bahama. The death toll stands at 163. Meanwhile, many Grand Bahamian businesses that were shut down due to the COVID-19 pandemic are now back in operation. With the country still under curfew and other restrictions, many businesses have been forced to find ways to stay afloat in these uncertain times. However, one small business in the downtown area is hoping that the approaching holidays will deliver a boost in business. Jay Philippe tells us more.
Many small businesses are succumbing to the economic challenges associated with the COVID-19 pandemic. Since March this year, when the pandemic struck the Bahamas, a number of businesses in Grand Bahama were forced to shut down. Get Your ice cream and treat store located downtown, has had its own share of challenges from experiencing significant damage due to Hurricane Dorian and now COVID-19. However, store supervisor Sinead Fox tells us that the store is committed to its employees.
Business hasn't been the same since the pandemic, but we try to keep everybody on. You know, it's rough and it's hard. Some families have one, two persons maybe working in the household. Some lost their jobs. So we try to keep everybody on.
Employee Cheyenne Dame says that business has been inconsistent due to recent lockdowns and curfew restrictions. However, they remain committed to their customers.
The business was okay. It was going okay at first, after the first lockdown. But after the second one, it kind of really slowed down. Sales really decreased, and it's been hard on the business since the second reopening.
The ice cream store offers over 50 different flavors with a variety of unique servings.
We have rolled ice cream, we have frappuccinos, we have more daiquiris and milkshakes, and we have a lot of toppings and a lot of things that you can add onto your ice cream and make it more an enjoyable experience.
The store is open from 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. daily with strict safety protocols and practices in place for customers and employees.
When customers enter, they have to keep their mask on, remain their mask on, keep social distances. We have the markers on the floor. As they enter, they have to sanitize, and there's no indoor dining allowed, but you can sit outside. Now, employees, of course, we have to sanitize every time we change our gloves, and we have to make sure we wash our hands very frequently to make sure we keep, and we also have to social distance when we are in the store together.
Sinead noting that Sundays are busy days where families show up in groups. She says her employees are particularly prepared on that day.
On Sundays, we usually put two ice cream trailers outside, sometimes one, just to eliminate the traffic in the store. So mostly for the kids, they can go outside and get whatever they like. And sometimes we have up to 9 to 16 different flavors outside, so that helps eliminate the traffic in the store.
Despite limits on capacity due to COVID-19 restrictions, Get Your Ice Cream Treats is looking forward to the upcoming holiday season. I'm Jay Philippe, ZNS Network News.
Thanks so much, Jay. In other news, AML is continuing to support the National Food Distribution Task Force through its annual Feed 5,000 Families initiative. Officials from AML Foods Limited officially launched the company's fifth annual Feed 5,000 Families holiday give back. Executives also announced that the company will jumpstart their goal of raising $90,000 with a $30,000 donation towards the initiative in celebration of their 30th year anniversary. From now until December 19th, AML is appealing to the general public and corporate Bahamas to purchase or donate towards the purchase of Christmas dinner packages valued at $40 at any Fresh Market, Solomon's, or Cost-Rite location in New Providence and Grand Bahama. The company is joining forces with the National Food Distribution Task Force, and all proceeds will be donated to the program to help families in New Providence and Grand Bahama. Vice President of Marketing and Communications at AML Foods Limited, Renea Bastian, noted that Bahamians are facing unprecedented hardships as a result of the COVID-19 outbreak, and now, more than ever, communities need their help. She added that it's a very difficult time for local food banks and community organizations tasked with feeding those in need, and AML is committed to assisting as much as they can. CEO and president at AML Foods, Gavin Watchhorn, adding that thanks to their company donations and the generosity of partners and the wider Bahamian community, they have raised over $400,000 to help families in need since starting the program in 2016. This year, their goal is to raise $90,000, $30,000 through AML donations, $30,000 through customer donations, and $30,000 from corporate sponsorships. It's Holly. Hallie- Police on Grand Bahama conducting a walkabout in the Heritage Subdivision off Settlers Way. The Community Policing Initiative is keeping with the Commissioner's Policing Plan 2020. Assistant Commissioner of Police and Officer in Charge of the Northern Bahamas, Ashton Greenslade, led the team of officers as they visited 23 homes in the Heritage community. While residents say they were pleased with the efforts of the officers in the Northeastern Division, they commended the officers for their frequent mobile patrols within the area, noting that their efforts have been very effective. Two males are in police custody after they were found to be in possession of a quantity of suspected marijuana. Reports of that on Monday, November 16, shortly after 11 a.m., officers of the flying squad, while on mobile patrol in the Limewood Lane area, observed the 2010 Nissan Altima with two male occupants parked partially in the middle of the road, obstructing traffic. While officers approached the vehicle and noticed a strong aroma of marijuana emanating from that vehicle, officers searched the occupants and the vehicle, where they discovered a quantity of suspected marijuana. Both males were arrested and are expected to be arraigned before the court this week.
This is Pastor Pinder here, along with my wife, Co-Pastor Grace, and we just want to encourage you. Amen. Somebody out there who has lost hope. Our mission and House of Hope is to restore hope to those who have lost hope. Our motto is not to let another wounded soldier die. To me, hope is a desire, amen, with a belief in the possibility of obtaining what is not achievable. We cannot see it, but yet we hope for it. Hope is also a trustful expectation of God's promises and favor that will come. Hallelujah. So let's keep hope alive. A few days ago, hallelujah, I encountered a young lady listening to a radio station, and her hope was to have a child in school. And right then, she heard her hope coming to life. There was a broadcast that came across that if there is anyone with a 3 or 4 year old who desires them to be in school, there was a spot available already paid for. Amen. And right then she heard her hope come to life. So I just want to encourage you out there. There is hope. God is still on the throne. He is able. So let's not lose hope in this time, in Jesus' name.
Sacrifice and the truth.